Can we harness the energy of the Earth's core? Iceland already is. 2/3 of its primary energy comes from a unique renewable source, geothermal. They are tapping gigantic hot water reservoirs underground to generate heat and electricity 24/7. Around the world, other countries want to replicate this success story.
Geothermal power plants.
The geothermal power industry.
But there is a catch. You can only do this in places with hot water reserves underground. And frankly, there aren't very many of them. But there is a new kid on the block, or should I say, in the rock. A new generation of geothermal technologies promise to make energy from the Earth's core available pretty much everywhere.
It's even available in downtown Paris that you can just simply, if you can drill, you can access to it.
Even Google is betting on new geothermal to power its data centers. Time to explore how we can drill into a new energy era and who stands to profit. But first, the basics. This is how deep a conventional geothermal operation runs. It varies, but they are roughly located a few hundred to 3,000 meters deep, where hot water reservoirs usually sit. The water is pumped up for district heating or power stations. For reference, oil and gas wells often run deeper, up to a depth of 4,000 meters. Geothermal 2.0 can go way deeper than that and doesn't need a hot water reservoir.
If you want this heat to be everywhere in the world, you go beyond 4,000.
This is Hemi Bahar from the International Energy Agency. He's been co-authoring a large report assessing geothermal's capacities.
Once you go beyond 4,000, between 4,000 and 7,000, it's basically it's like a wind resource or a solar resource, right? So it's everywhere.
The Earth has different layers, and the deeper you go, the warmer it gets as you go closer to the core. That's 5,000 degrees Celsius. On average, the temperature increases by 25 to 30 degrees per kilometer you go down. So the deeper you drill, the more energy you can potentially harvest. Look at these maps. Those are promising locations for geothermal at 2,000 meters below surface, where the Earth itself is 150 degrees or more. This is considered warm enough for heat and electricity generation. This is how many you'll find at 4,000 and at 7,000 meters. All these sites combined could unlock energy to provide 150 times our annual global electricity demand. But just drilling deeper won't bring up the energy. So how can we do that? One way is currently being explored in this quaint village in Bavaria, Germany. The Canadian company Eavor is planning to open their first commercial geothermal power plant here in 2026.
The special thing about our technology, it's not only the pure depth where we drill.
Daniel Merck is in charge of Eavor's operation in Germany.
It is that we can drill many different wells out of one mother well, so we can fan them out. We can drill them very, very long, beyond 8,000 meters length. And then we can interconnect them, seal them, and build this large subsurface radiator.
They call this Eavor loop, a closed loop system. The key point, it works without a hot water reservoir underground, as it extracts heat from dry rocks. I reconstructed the process for you. Two wells are drilled 5,000 meters vertically into the earth. From there, several lateral well bores fan out and intersect the two main wells. Cold water is then pumped through the tubes. As it flows through the hot rock, it absorbs the heat and brings it back to the surface. There, it can be used to keep houses warm via district heating systems or turned into electricity using a steam turbine. Eavor is investing 350 million euros into geothermal and has several patents on their technologies. A second project is already planned in the north of Germany, which would cover up to 20% of the heating requirements of Hanover with its 500,000 inhabitants. But Eavor isn't the only company going deep underground.
Extremely visible and talked about is one project in the United States who is basically using the hydraulic fracturing technology.
Enter Google. They need renewable energy, a lot of it, to power their data centers. That's why in 2021, they made a deal with startup Fervo Energy to build a new type of geothermal plant in the Nevada desert. Their approach involves creating an artificial hot water reservoir. In order to do this, Fervo drilled two wells of about 2,500 meters. After that, they turned the bore heads and kept drilling horizontally. The idea being that horizontal drilling makes the heat transfer process more efficient and boosts water throughput. Once they reach their ideal position, a fluid, usually water, gets pumped into the ground under huge pressure, fracturing stones and rocks. Water is then pumped into the wells, flows through the cracks in the rocks, heats up, and is pushed to the surface. If this all sounds familiar, that's because the same approach is used in fracking to extract oil and gas. It's all been done before in geothermal research trials in the 70s, particularly in Europe, but Fervo seems to have taken it to the next level.
In the short period of time, they were able to reduce the cost by 50%, drilling time by 70%, and now they are basically drilling for a 370 or almost 400 megawatt project in Utah. This is where the excitement is coming from.
Their first commercial prototype power plant in Nevada is small in comparison, at 3.5 megawatts. But it's up and running, and the industry is watching the second one in Utah to see if it really can harvest 100 times that amount. But amid all the hype, there is an important side effect. Earthquakes.
Korean government has designated the quake-hit port city of Pohang in the nation's southeast as a special disaster zone.
Korea 2017. A magnitude 5.4 earthquake in Pohang injured dozens and 1,700 people had to move into emergency housing. It was caused by enhanced geothermal exploration.
It produced a big shock, and that was the end of that project, unfortunately.
This is William Ellsworth, professor at Stanford University and the expert when it comes to seismic activities and risk assessments.
So it was a very serious event. And this was a case where we later identified that their attempt to create the geothermal reservoir had instead stimulated a fault, and one of those earthquakes ran away.
Cracking up rocks down in the earth to make way for water to flow sometimes causes multiple mini earthquakes. These can get out of control, setting off a snowball effect.
And we also know that as we go deeper into the earth, the forces get larger. So there is potential for more release of energy in earthquakes.
The risk of earthquakes has led to public opposition and bans in some areas. Fervo says its operation has been safe and monitored throughout the process.
Monitoring very carefully is one of the key goals. Also doing very careful assessment of the geology beforehand so that we avoid known faults and other things that may be problematic during the development or operation of a plant.
Another drawback of enhanced geothermal technology is that it uses lots of water. Closed-loop systems, like the one Eavor is building in Bavaria, use less water and don't need to disturb the ground as much, reducing the risk of triggering an earthquake. But it's more expensive to drill the long and deep wells needed for it. As with nearly all cool breakthrough technologies, the biggest factor that's holding back next-gen geothermal is money.
This is the key point. Whether geothermal will take off or not.
The IEA expects that without subsidies, electricity from new geothermal would be several times more expensive than solar and wind.
It is important to sort of posit this as a fast changing technology suite where we are getting better at it every day and demonstrating it more every day.
This is Tara Rogers. She's the head of the research unit for harvesting super hot rocks at NGO Clean Air Task Force.
But within that first of kind, which is where we are today, we expect that most of the first of kind facilities are going to occur where that heat is most shallow.
This is for a simple reason. Digging to depth of 4, 5, or even 10,000 meters lets you harvest more energy, but at a much higher cost. To keep that cost down, this clean renewable energy could join forces with and give a boost to an unlikely ally. Big oil and gas.
Candidly, from a climate perspective, we need that size of player in order to meet our expectations with climate. They are the ones that can move this fastest and deploy in a timeline that really matters.
Basically, drilling, cementing, finishing, closing the wells, even managing the large projects, which involves under the ground, their knowledge of subsurface environment and so on and so forth. It's 80%, which means that if you spend $100, $80 of this is basically oil and gas industry's bread and butter.
The drilling techniques Fervo Energy and Eavor use rely substantially on technology and methods invented for fracking in the early 2000s. Today at Fervo, 90% of the work time is covered by oil and gas workers. And Fervo's and Eavor's founders and management have a long history in the fossil fuel industry. There's even talk of repurposing old oil and gas wells into geothermal sites. But so far, the fossil fuel industry has only invested $140 million in new geothermal development, which may sound like a lot, but in the grand scheme of things, is close to nothing.
They are waiting and trying to see whether an innovation breakthrough is going to happen for geothermal as well.
Which leads to a bit of a stalemate, because that innovation breakthrough won't happen without lots of investment. The IEA says the geothermal sector would need $1 trillion in the next 10 years to unlock its full potential. Better regulation is also needed, or any at all. Today, less than 30 countries have some kind of regulation in place. What is promising is that those countries also provide grants, debt or insurance schemes to mitigate risks and high initial costs. Eavor is supported with more than 100 million euros by the EU. In the US, Fervo has profited from government support. Next generation geothermal technology holds the promise of unlocking a form of energy for places that could not tap into it previously. It is developing quickly and could particularly bolster electricity security in Asia by substituting coal or complementing solar and wind in Europe.
These next generation geothermal projects will not only provide a profile of electricity that is very unique, this 24/7 firm, clean profile, but it also simultaneously provides quality jobs. These are paid, well-paid, full-time jobs that look exactly like those that were previously needed or currently needed in a lot of the subsurface recovery of fossil fuels.
China, the United States, and India are most promising regions. Together, they hold 3/4 of the global geothermal market potential. If the technology keeps developing, stays safe, and costs come down even more, it could deliver at least 15% of the entire global electricity demand by 2050. And with greater depths, even more, which would be huge. And it could throw big oil and gas a lifeline, a new renewable business model that still lets them do what they do best. Drill, baby, drill, but leaving fossil fuels in the ground.
What's your take on the future of geothermal energy? We have new environmental stories for you every Friday.